So, how did Stegosaurus have sex? Welcome to the Natural History of Dinosaurs. My name is Benjamin Berger. I'm a paleontologist at Utah State University, teaching in the heart of Utah's dinosaur country in Vernal. In this video, we'll look at Stegosaurus to reconstruct its life habits, including possible mating strategies, and discuss as much as we can about the life of this bizarre dinosaur. Stegosaurus and other stegosaurians are noted for having these large plates along the back of the animal. Now, there's been wide speculation about what these stegosaur plates were used for. There's three major hypotheses. The first is that these were for protection from predators, or they were used for sexual display, like the tail of male peacocks. And finally, there's a hypothesis that they were used for thermoregulation to help warm the blood in the animal. Now, having large plates rather than simple spikes might have developed in response to protecting the animal from large predators. Now, advocates of this idea point to the possibility that these plates could be lowered and raised, and by doing so, they would change the profile of the dinosaur from the side. Looking big is really important because it would deter large predators from trying to take on a larger animal. So by raising up these plates along the back would make the animal look bigger without having to add much body mass to the animal. Now, elephants take advantage of their large size to scare away lions, and likely there was pressure for large sizes with Stegosaurus having to defend itself from predatory dinosaurs like Allosaurus. Sexual display has become a favorite hypothesis recently, especially with these recent papers advocating for some sexual differences between male and female individuals. Now, both sexes had plates, but maybe they were used to distinguish individuals. There's some evidence that the plates were covered in keratin and were heavily vascularized underneath. So they may have been much larger than what we normally estimate based on the bones, and they might have been able to change color with blood flowing past underneath a transparent keratin sheath over them. The final hypothesis is maybe these plates were used for thermoregulation, that the heavy vascularized bone would help keep the blood warm, although This idea has kind of fallen out of favor recently as more and more paleontologists have been advocating for warm-bloodedness in dinosaurs. Now, another aspect of the behavior of Stegosaurus is whether they lived in herds or whether the animal was a solitary creature. Fossil skeletons and bones are common in the Morrison Formation here in North America, but there's been no large bone beds of just Stegosaurus fossils being found to date. Most of the skeletons that have been found are isolated individuals, or they're jumbled into an assemblage of other dinosaur bones. Trackways are also isolated, and it does not appear that Stegosaurus traveled in large groups like many other ornithischian dinosaurs like horned ceratopsians and ornithopod duck-billed dinosaurs. We can imagine that Stegosaurus was more of a solitary animal, more like a living rhinoceros rather than a herd of wildebeests. Now, one of the puzzling things about Stegosaurus is that they have these very tiny non-grinding teeth. And one of the things that we've discovered is with Stegosaurus is like living birds, they had what are called gastroliths within their stomach. These are basically stones or rocks that are swallowed, and they would fall down into the croup or fore stomach in the digestive tract of the dinosaurs. Chickens do this by ingesting stones and rocks and using them to help digest food in the gut. And that's because they lack teeth and they need to digest food and break them down, and they use these stones in the four-chambered parts of the stomach that rub together and break apart the food before it enters into the stomach. Now, this is a useful behavior since Stegosaurus would not have to worry about wearing out and replacing teeth. The animal could always just swallow a few rocks to help in the process of digestion. All right, finally, we come to the great puzzling question. How did Stegosaurus mate? How did Stegosaurus have sex? you know, with all these plates along the back and long tail spikes, how did this work? Now, to answer this question, we can use a scientific technique called the phylogenetic bracket. Now, a phylogenetic bracket states that if a trait or behavior is found bracketing a group on a tree, on a cladogram, we can assume that it was likely present in the extinct forms. Now, since living crocodilians and living birds bracket the extinct Stegosaurus, we can study the sexual mating practices of crocodilians and birds to get an understanding of how Stegosaurus might have mated. Both crocodilians and birds have a single vaginal and anal opening called the cloaca. This opening is where the penis is inserted during sex to transport sperm into the female. In crocodiles, the penis is a collagen-filled organ which is pushed out of the body during sex. The organ is stiff and it does not increase in size with blood flow like in mammals. In birds, if they do have a penis, it's inflated with air, which is connected to the air sac system of the bird's anatomy. Now, both groups copulate quickly, following a long mating song or dance, some sort of ritual to attract mates. This style of mating behavior was likely found in Stegosaurus. In looking at animals, crocodilians, the bodies of the mating pair often will twist or twine around each other in an embrace. In birds, the male is on the back of the female. Now, the two hypothesized proposed sexual mating positions for Stegosaurus is that the female would lay on her side, pointing the plates and spikes away from the male. Or the two Stegosaurus would back up to each other, the butt-to-butt sexual position. In my own opinion, is that the female Stegosaurus would lie on her side. And that might be one of the reasons why we don't see spikes that come off the thighs of Stegosauria. Kind of like what you see with some of the other genera of Thyrophorians, which have weld-armored shoulder spikes. But none of these animals have spikes, long spikes that come off the thighs. And that might be a reason for that, is that they were laying on their side during mating. All right, so hopefully this video shows you how we can sort of justify some of the life habits of Stegosaurus, such as herding, thermoregulation, digestion of food, and sexual mating practices from just fossil bones and trace fossils.